Judea Black, Shalom L'Chaim, purified drink of water, they got it, it's out there. Shouts out to the 12 tribes, support the people, not the cause, man. I hope tomorrow finds you safer than today and yesterday, and I hope today found you safer than yesterday and the day before that. You know, support the people, not the cause, man. Like I said, I ain't here to convert you or I ain't here to give you information to turn you into something or sit here and argue with you if the color is blue or the color is purple, if it's a color in between that when it's dry it's blue and when it's wet it looks purple. Not here for that. I'm not here to tell you that I'm not a Jew or I'm a Jew or I'm not a Hebrew, I'm a Hebrew, or I'm not supporting Cushetic or the Ashkenazis or not the Khazars, or I'm not here to do any of that because I never once and never will be blasphemous. And for two, you can't tell me what I am from what you are. I literally have lineage and you possibly do too. So get at your boy. Let's talk about this. Anyway, we were just talking about the Negro anthem, and that's funny because it's like the national anthem for Negroes, and I've seen this a lot in school, and I've seen it a lot like public schools, people gather together and put the blacks in a room and give away Jamaican colored awards, Rastafarian colored awards and shit, you know, to the kids for being an outstanding presence as a black person and whatever. Yeah, so we got into that. I got another video for that. This is more of the Negroes National Anthem again. I believe I got one more today besides my commercial. Then we get on up and get on from there and then move on tomorrow. So, again, support the people, not the cause, man. Shouts out to the 12 tribes. Check out my waters down here. Got the waters down here. And the pass along, man. I hope y'all passing along. Email me if y'all ain't get a water. Yeah, email me if you want a water. Pay shipping. Let's go. Judea Black, Shalom L'Chaim, purified drink of water. They got it. It's out there. Shouts out to the Joel Tribe. Support the people, not the cause, man. And it is what it is. Cue that music out.
Robin Peter to paper.
Every Voice and Sing is a song that I have heard all my life. It was written by two brothers, James Weldon Johnson and J. Rosamond Johnson, in 1900. They grew up in Jacksonville, Florida, but had to leave Jacksonville to go to Atlanta for schooling because there was no schools for colored in Jacksonville. While in Atlanta, both worked to wash dishes in restaurants to support themselves. After graduation, they returned to Jacksonville and sought employment. They both were employed in the then established Jacksonville Colored Schools. In 1900, a celebration was planned to recognize Abraham Lincoln's birthday, and the Johnsons were asked to write a song and present it at the celebration. It was then that they wrote, "Lift Every Voice and Sing." Please note that it's written in a very definite and intentional manner. There are three stanzas, and I was taught that each of them should be sung each time we sing it. The first one is that of rejoicing. It says, "Lift every voice and sing, till earth and heaven ring. Ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicings rise high as the listening skies. Let it resound loud as the rolling seas." The second stanza became a little bit sad as it depicted slavery and the scars it had left. It said, "Stony the road we trod, bitter the chastening rod, felt in the days when hope unborn had died, yet with a steady beat have now our weary feet come to the place for which our fathers sighed." The third stanza moves us from the joyous description of the first through the sadness of the second and into the anticipation of God's continuous guidance. God of our weary years, God of our silent tears, Thou who hast brought us thus far on the way, Thou who hast by Thy might led us into the light, keep us forever in the path, we pray. There are no personal pronouns in this song. The words us, we, and our suggest unity. So when we sing this song, let us reflect on the circumstance under which it was written and pledge ourselves to be true to our God and to our native land.